quote, is immune to damage, or something. Which means that you get to ride on the insects. Unfortunately, I landed on the wrong side of the insect in question. So, he turned around. And started flying in the wrong direction. Which would have wasted a whole lot of time. What is your favorite track from System Shock 2 on 1? Which, by the way, Blue Twitch, if you have played System Shock 2, then you have heard that music somewhere before. It is the second command deck track. Ops 2. Yeah. Yeah, I like the Ops music. I like alt music, really. Watched it being happen? Maybe not. The Command Deck 2 track is not in the current iteration of the any percent speedrun for that game. Well, I didn't get the boost, but I also didn't get the joyride, so I guess I'm fine with that. These drops have been pretty good too, anyways, so. key to joy. Please register my button inputs. Pretty good fight by my standards. That's what we call inattentional blindness. I literally didn't see that thing because I was just not there at all. Please stop trying to kill me. I learned my lesson. I swear, I'll never come back to Egg Corridor. Bizarre, but I am alive. Have not been great. I should get level 2 on the way back though. You weren't using that, right? I'll just help myself. Okay, not the fastest jelly kill, but I did get the boost up here properly, and that's pretty cool. The question is, do I get this trick first time? Probably not, but you know, whatever. Oh, I got it. The hype is real. What am I doing? I'm like intentionally throwing a run. That's bad. Did somebody over here drop hearts? No. No, nothing over here. Oh, that's cute. That's really cute. I like that. Damn. I've been slow through that section, so I kind of wanted to speed up, but I wound up taking a lot of damage that I don't usually take there, because I haven't practiced going fast, and now I could very easily die in this fight. Someone. Managed to make it through it, I guess. I don't really like that. I don't want to go down to level 2. I think I can take one hit off of this, and then I'll de-level my fireball to level 2. And then I'll just have to live with it. Whatever I get at that point. Oh, that sucks. That sucks even more. I didn't need that life and or experience anyway. Okay. It's cute. Everybody loves Balfrog. I'm not sure that's a proposition that is true. I was correct in my assumption that that proposition was not true. M1 does not love Balfrog. Just that much easier. Oops. Doesn't matter. I think that's the best I've done that section before. I took it a little bit slower, just like a little bit, and changed up the way that I was firing the fireballs. I like the Sand Zone fetch quest. Yeah, but you know. The Sand Zone fetch quest involves something that's cute, not a block of charcoal. Grass Town is dumb and only good because of the house skip. Despite the fact that I screw it up, I do kind of like the boost or the jump up off of the marshmallow thing. To get up to the jelly kill the second time. Speaking of jelly kills, though, my first one was actually pretty good. Second one, not so much. But I'm okay with one for two. Grass Town's fetch quest, I mean. Oh, you like Grass Town, otherwise. Oops. I thought Curly was going to start moving more quickly there. She did not. And I fireballed into the wrong direction. Hey, Pooch. I'm not sure that that's necessary, but I'm doing it anyways. Yeah, probably is necessary. These Polishes and the Gators hurt like a whole lot. Kind of screwed that up a little bit, but that's fine. Wait, what? I thought this is a speedrun. What are you doing getting those? Getting what? The hell? I used too many missiles there, but it's fine. What? Oh, jeez. Whatever, I'm getting more back here. Why do I suddenly not know where any of my weapons are? Now I don't have any missiles. Ah, jeez. Whatever. It's fine. Come on, Cloak, get up there. Getting the item in the darkness of Curly's house? Oh. Come on, dude. Quote is a red-blooded robot. Gotta make sacrifices. And if you want to blame someone, you should blame M1. He's a bad influence on me. I have never raided panties until I watched M1 speedrun. I learned it from you. Why am I so bad at this game? Just drop experience for the love of Batman. Ooh. It's four times down mine. Great. So that wasn't good. But it could have been worse. It could have been much worse. Does this mean that you get the lipstick and the alien metal too? What am I gonna use the lipstick for? Or the alien metal for that matter? My controller refuses to register down as a button. I haven't been a big fan of these drops. It's kind of been junky. Clearly we have different priorities here. You betcha. Wow. Okay. What do we got? Level 2 and level 2? That's balls, man. That is balls, and I'm probably going to lose even more experience on them here because of birds. Okay, I'm not going to die here. I didn't die. Mission accomplished. Congratulations, everybody. Medals all around. But not alien medals. Kill these things here, but I'm going to anyways. Okay, that gives me level 3 on my missile launcher, which is kind of nice. I really need experience on my flamethrower there, because that's like seriously underleveled. And it needs to be seriously not underleveled for the fight with Taroko. Stop and kill a couple more of these boneheads on the way. I mean, level 2 is okay, but I would rather have level 3 or at least some kind of buffer. That's good. Particularly because I'm probably going to be taking damage going through here anyway. All day. And while I shouldn't need to heal for this fight, because I practiced the shit out of it, it has been a while. I guess I didn't believe that hard. Most of the time that I'm losing there is because I was getting the extra EXP for my fireball.
Okay.
still stopping to kill that guy. I don't know why. Why do I kill Taroka? I think I covered that close to the... Oh. I have no ammo. There we go. Close to the beginning of the game. Quote, is a robot that is designed to destroy everything in its path, including chin fishes, small bunnies, insects, you name it, man. Quote is an amoral killing machine. Since I saved, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. That cockroach that jumps down is a jerk. I equipped the wrong weapon. I'm out of here. Still feels kind of odd that it's not worth getting the supercharger for the machine gun. I don't think it really saves that much time. Or it wouldn't, anyways. Having it, I mean. It would be convenient, I guess. But... well, that was great. Massive success. I almost got them, actually. Not that far off. My mid-game and my PB was, halfway decent. It's Dr. Booster. I'll just shoot at him and then move on. Ideally, you don't take enough damage to lose level 3. Jackass. I was in the air. There's no eating of me in the air allowed. I did not know that he could do that. That's annoying. And now I do not have a whole lot of health going in here, which is unfortunate, but I'll have to see how I do. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna see if I can get Scum some extra hearts out of these. Okay, I am really hurt here, and this is not a good health position for me again. So, I am going to lose some time with the goal of surviving Lab M. I'm gonna do when I get to the frickin' core. I guess I just have to hope that he drops shit on his, on his projectiles. I gotta save here. I will say this, that wasn't the best Lab M. But I'm still actually pretty pleased about it, because I had a bit of a disaster with the machine gun, and while it cost me some time, I'm still getting here with missiles at level 2, and I recovered okay, so I'm at least happy about that. Because everything going, you know, not perfectly is... You know, I mean, that's just how speedrunning goes anyways. But being able to deal with it when shit happens is a really good way of marking whether or not I'm getting better at the game. Satellite pattern sucks. Oi. I'm bleeding out a lot of the time that I gained early on. Well, that's okay. You are coming with me. Yep, I'm still ahead. Some of that fight was... some of that fight was definitely me, but I also think that a good chunk of that fight was, not great luck with the satellites. Or at least not good enough for me to deal with it. Saving it. I love that secret sound effect. That's so funny. I know I just saved, but I'm doing it again anyway. No idea what that's supposed to mean, actually. We'll be right back. Did I really just do that? Yes, I did. Please, game, forgive me. No. Are you kidding? I really hope there's a health thing in here. My mid-game has sucked. On to life here, M1. I'm not giving it up. I'm trying. Trying to stick with it. Well, there goes that 7 seconds. Mushroom fight, or for machine boosting, or for anything. Damn. Get that boost. Rapscallions. I've been imprisoned. Kind of. Oh, missile, that'll come in handy. Sure. Didn't mean to save there. Wanted to. Just wanted to heal up before this fight. Please don't do that. Ah, well. I can technically still PB because I spent an enormous amount of time in hell. But this has not been tremendously great in terms of keeping the dream alive. Why would I press up to open the door when I can press down? I'm going to be losing more time here because this green-haired harpy has just stolen my jetpack. Too much Yoshi's Island? I'm not sure I get that. Oh, wow. Okay. M1. Hold me. Could you move, dude? Thank you. Hey, Spoodie. How's it going? I thought she was supposed to be like an engineer or something. Like, how is she building a freaking jetpack out of a sprinkler? She's like, no, the broken one isn't any good. Well, fix it then. Get out of here, you stupid pea. I hate you. Mm-hmm. she has the schematics for a rocket. She doesn't have the instructions for a sprinkler. Well, she's no MacGyver, I'll tell you that much. God, this is perilous. Up yours, bats. Hating myself with impossible spell card lately. I do not know of this thing. But if you're hating yourself for it, I'm guessing it is some manner of guilty pleasure. Which are often the most awesome kinds of pleasures. New Toho game that came out last week-ish. Cool. You know, it's fun. I'm just going to get level 2 on this thing, and then I'm going to leave the final cave. Bad. I don't have a lot of health for this fight and the next fight. Yeah, I should be like 5 health now? 2 health, oh yay. This is gonna be a good core fight. I'm literally going to leave these splits. I don't care about Misery or the Doctor that much. I want something to measure when I get a final cave, but that's about it. And then the undead core. The other ones... I don't give a darn. Hey, Sherry. It has been a while. How are you doing? I've had a couple of pretty bad runs back-to-back. Llama Llama was like 8 minutes ahead, but 5 minutes of that was kind of like fairy shenanigans. And then this one started off really well and has just kind of gone down the drain. I don't know how the rest of this fight's gonna go, but I don't have a good feeling about it. I have an even less good feeling about it now. I think I spent that much time doing damage to Sue, but... okay. I had many mistakes after Egg-Zero. But yes. Some of them were big. Faux gold. Well, if I don't die in hell, then this bizarre run will suddenly become my personal best. I don't know how I feel about that. But regardless of that, I will feel good about getting hell on the first try. That's always kind of nice. Okay, I didn't get denied, and yet that didn't really cut the mustard. I don't understand. Whatever. gonna take this safe because I came through the tile room with not a lot of health. So I'm gonna see what I can get from these guys in terms of heart drops. Alright, this is an okay position to be in, I guess. Oh, he's got a psychopathic frickin' Butte coming after me. Oh, that's not good. Totally scooping those hearts. Health should be enough. Hey, Seven, happy birthday. Welcome to the Over 30 Club. Or 30 or Over Club. Just missed it. Almost. Look at all that time, man. Yeah, that's actually definitely M1. I beat my best by 23 seconds there. That's pretty good. And I wasn't... I don't know. That wasn't a super quick hell or anything, but... In fact, I stopped to do... like, grab extra hearts and different things. But... yeah, regardless of the fact that I'm, like, 7 minutes ahead, and that's a, like, you know, that's a good PB, I think, in terms of how much of a percentage I've improved on my run just from that last split alone. I'm happy with the run in the respect that It's like what I was saying at the core fight, or right before the core, when I went through Lab M. Things went wrong in this run, unequivocally. But I managed to pull it back and keep in it. Like, a lot of stuff went wrong and I had to resort to a lot of back strats and persevere. And I managed to finish the run. Without dying, right? I don't think I died in this run. I mean, you know, some things were slow, but I don't think I had to load at any point, which is cool, I guess. A lot of more time to come off though. Alright, I'm glad I pleased you, Seven. world record for this game is 57-something, 57-11, I believe. By PPU. So, I'm a ways off, but improving slowly. If I had a run that was a little bit more overall good, I'd probably be within maybe not within 10 minutes. I mean, it depends. I don't remember what my gold splits for some of these are. You know, where I lost, like, a little bit of time, but you know, maybe that doesn't all convert to time that I can save, even off of my golds. 608 disc 1. Damn. That is nice. You're really starting to carve that up. Remember the first set of splits you set were like 950 or something like that? Shaving off big chunks. It's always good. Like me with that last split. Oh, I'm behind by 2 minutes, behind by 2 minutes, behind by 2 minutes. Oh, I found 9 minutes out of nowhere. Who knew that not dying was fast? Ah, jeez. That was fun though.